For us, we have a basis for thankfulness, and we ought to really be grateful all the time. Gratitude is the most exquisite form of courtesy. We are happy for Dr. Miss Feliselda, and I'm glad that the work in Congo and Zambia is going on, and we need to pray for them. Mom Rory, where's Mom Rory? Mom Rory, please stand, Mom Rory. Yeah, give a big hand, Mom Rory. And of course, Dr. Feliselda, our missionary to the Congo and Zambia, brother, give a big hand to all my brothers.
Salamat, Pastor, for the privilege of preaching the word tonight. Sadyang gitawagan kong Pastor Kent nga ako muwali karong gabi una. O ako kabalibad, mga kaigsunan, bisan di ko kakita kayo sa akong mga notes because I really have some problems with my eye and I am scheduled to have surgery this December 20. So Pastor Gisalba was saying that the future is a questionnaire, but never be afraid of the unknown future with a known God. I know whom I have believed, and I am persuaded that He is able to keep that which I have committed unto Him against that day. Sa niadto sa nagasulat-sulat pa ko og mga poem, I remember that I wrote about the future. The future is merely a shadow that blocks out the joys of the present and emphasizes the sorrows of the past. Mauna nga, ayaw mo og huna-huna kayo sa future kay muamabot pa na. Ang huna-hunaon nato karon unya atong buhaton among the best that we can be able to do today so that we will be able to glorify our God. I was attending the meeting that they had this afternoon regarding the different ministries dito sa bukid. Unya nalipay ko nang nagapaminaw sa ilaha. Unya I was able to realize that the same thing that we were doing during the time that We had been extension pastors in the different extension churches. There is atong simbahan, nalipay ko naguna-huna because the experience that I experienced, they experienced also. Mga kaigsoonan, when I started my ministry as a pastor of Talisay Bible Baptist Church, every Tuesday, magtipok mi dire kay naaman mi meeting. Mitingon mi ni Pastor Gisalba. Unya, that is the time that we are actually having a fellowship with the different extension pastors. And during that time, ako silang dadun sa balay, unya, mangaon mi, and we talk about the ministry. And during that time, mga kaigsoonan, I like to talk to all the pastors, especially to my fellow pastors, about the work of the Lord. Storya mi sa buluhaton sa Ginoo, mga kaigsoonan. But when I became a missionary, There was a big difference because mga kaigsoonan, during the time that I was a pastor, there had been a lot of things that I made a mistake. Mauna nga, kitang tanan mga kaigsoonan, dili ta mga pure. There are things in our hearts that actually we have to ask forgiveness from the Lord. But when I became a missionary, I came to realize that it is not a matter of working for the Lord, but a matter of being possessed by the Lord. Mga kaigsoonan, kung dili ka possessed sa Ginoo, mga kaigsoonan, you probably will be working, but you will not be working totally for God. But if you are possessed by God, mga kaigsoonan, it is His glory that will flow through us. And that flow will be the real work. Mga kaigsoonan, kung dili ang flow sa Ginoo ang mugawas gikan kanato, dili makita ang tinuod nga pagtrabaho para sa Ginoo. I came to realize, mga kaigsoonan, nga pwede ta magtrabaho. Usahay gani, maglimbong patas atong i-report. Kay di man tininuod ang atong pagtrabaho, mga kaigsoonan, pero kung giposes ka sa Ginoo, di ka pwedeng manglimbong. Mga igsoon, kung wala ang Ginoo, wala tay ministry. In fact, during the time that we were in Congo, Africa, my wife and I, tinanaway mi, unsay atong buhaton diri? Because we really don't know what to do. You don't know the language. Unya, lisod kayo mga kaigsunan, but tungod kay na ay Ginoo nga mi-guide nimo. Unya, ang Ginoo nga naa kanimo, may misulti kanimo kung unsay buhaton. Unya, siya po'y nagdala og mga tao nga mutabang kanimo mga kaigsunan. Ang ministry na adiha. Mauna nga, dili gyud ta mahadlok sa future. Kaya ang future, gibuhat na nagtanaw na ang Ginoo kanato. Mauna nga, the outflow of God, mga kaigsunan, is the real ministry. Maubitaw na, nagtanaw-tanaw ko diri sa ministry, sa atong emeritus nga pastor, mga kaigsunan, nindot kaayo, nga naman, tungod kay gigamit siya sa Ginoo, og the outflow of the glory of God, nakita sa iyang kinabuhi. Now, it is not a matter of message. Mga kaigsunan, daghang maayo kayo manulting ang mga pastor or mga teachers. Any kind of teaching is not a matter of just anything. But I believe that it is a matter of being permeated by Jesus Christ. And then, He will flow out of us. And this flow is the work and the service and the flow of life. Mga kaigsunan, daghang kayong mga pastors karon diha sa Facebook o uban pa nga mga social media nag-away-away. Mga Baptist pag yun na. Aron makita lamang kung unsa ang ilang mga doktrina, unya ilang ipakita ang ilang knowledge about the Bible. Mga kaigsunan, sultihan ta mo. If you regard the Bible as knowledge, you will surely die. Because there were two trees in the Garden of Eden. The tree of life and the tree of knowledge of good and evil. Unya, nag-aingon ang Bible that if you eat that fruit of the tree of knowledge of good and evil, you shall surely die. The tree of knowledge of good, kaon ka, patay. The tree of knowledge of evil, patay gihapon. That means to say nga, dili pwede ang Biblia himuon imong knowledge because the most important is it is supposed to be a book of life. It is supposed to change you. It is supposed to change me. Mga kaigsunan, mauna nga, the service and the flow of life, kita mutuo gyud sa atong Ginoong Hesukristo nga kita mabag-o. Kay kung wala ko bagwa sa Ginoo, ambot asa ko karon, mga kaigsuonan. Now, I believe that God does not qualify us because we are eloquent, because we are knowledgeable, because we know Bible exposition. Instead, I believe that He looks at us because of our history and experience before the Lord. Nga nung kita nagarespeto sa atong pastor because nakita nato ang iyang experience, ang iyang history before the Lord. Kada usa-usa ka nato, nato experience before the Lord. Unya ka ng experience before the Lord, mga kaigsunan. Salamat sa Ginoo nga ang Ginoo mao ang nagpa-experience ka nako sa iyang himaya o sa iyang kaayo sa akong kinabuhi. Kaya kung wala pa, mga kaigsunan, I will say, I am, you know, I should have drifted. Tingalig na daot na kukaroon, mga kaigsunan. Kita nga mga Kristuhanon, some of us claim that we are Christians, but how much of your Christianity will remain in you if you get out from this place? Kahuman probably sa service karong gabi una, muuli ka, ngadto ka nas gawas, wala na'y makakita kanimo, Kristuhanon pa ka. Huna-huna ako nuna, mga kaigsuunan, sometimes, kita nga ni Adere, we have theology without Christ. You know, I had a chance to talk to a brother from a church in a village very far from my place. It was in Tinki Pungurumi, that is where the uranium is located. Dako ka na nga area unya dili mi kasulod dito tungod kay naay mga Americans and they are guarding the uranium mines. Now, this particular brother of ours is uneducated. Pero nakita ko sa iyang kinabuhi, mga kaigsunan, he is a humble man. He is really following the Lord in some ways that he believed, mga kaigsunan. Probably, wala siya makabalo sa different doctrines about the Baptist. Probably, I may be able to tell him about the different doctrines of the Baptist. Pero mga kaigsunan, but I perceive that he knows the truth. I perceive that he experienced the Lord as his victory in day-to-day life. Probably, I can talk to him and I can tell him about prophetic interpretations. Di magyugumayo prophetic interpretation, mga kaigsunan. Probably, I can tell him about how to pray. Probably, I can be able to impart to him some knowledge. But other than that, what testimony can I give him? I can tell him many things that probably he does not know. And I'm probably may think that I am more qualified as a worker of God than him. But am I sure that my spiritual insight before the Lord is deeper than him? Una-una ako no, mga kaigsunan, kay kamo man lang nakabalo sa imong kaugalingon o Ginoo. God knows our heart. Think about this. Sometimes this type of person have deeper spiritual insight before the Lord than what we have. Because we probably know the teaching about Jesus Christ, but this person knows about Christ. Kaya ang tinuod nga relasyon sa Ginoo, mga kaigsunan, dili na makuha lamang sa atong pag-istorya about what we read from the Bible. Kana experience na, unya ang experience nga imong nakita sa imong kinabuhi, unya kana nagbag-o sa imong kinabuhi, mga kaigsunan. Mao na karong gabi una, let's open our Bible to Matthew chapter 13. Verse 23, let us all stand up to give reverence to the Word of God. Matthew chapter 13, verse 23, the Bible says, "But he that receiveth seed into the good ground is he that heed the word." Mga kaigsunan, timan ini. He that heed the word and understand it. And then, which also beareth fruit and bringeth forth some hundredfold, some 60, some 30. Magamputa. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for the opportunity that you have given to me to be able to come and preach your word. Salamat kay Pastor Gisalba, kay Pastor Kent, sa simbahan, Ginoo, sa mga faithful members of the church. Oh my Lord, look upon the doubts and discouragement of our ministries. And keep us from our self-importance. Nangayong magpasaylo, Ginoo, sa mga salang among nabuhat, omissions, infirmities, as men of God, as children of God, as ministers, command your blessings in your weak and worthy labors and the message of salvation given. Mga, stay with your people. And may your presence be their portion and mine. Lord, hinaut unta nga when I preach, let not my word be merely elegant and masterly. But Lord, allow that I may be able to glorify you and exalt you. And we will be able to humble ourselves so that we can be able really to follow you. I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Mga kaigsunan, think about this. Sumala sa akong gisulti usahay na ay mga tao nga naapay knowledge ka nato kontra sa atong Ginoo, kontra ka nato nga nagasulti ta nga mga Kristohanon. Karong gabi una, the truth that I will be sharing to you is not a new truth, but it is a neglected truth. Your knowledge of it probably is necessary if you want to have a true ministry. Tungod kay kita tanan na amay tay mga ministry. Walay tao diri nga walay ministry. Gitagaan ta sa Ginoo og trabaho. When Jesus said, all power is given unto me in heaven and earth. And then he said, go ye therefore. Kada usa-usa nga anak sa Dios, kung gidawat nimo si Kristo, nga personal nimong manluluwas, naa kay ministry. Ha? Mauna, mga kaigsunan, we have to understand this. And let us open our Bibles to three powerful verses. Because it will properly allow us to understand and will greatly increase our ability to receive from God. And we can fulfill the ministry. I was looking at grace and thanksgiving. Mga kaigsunan, bisan gani kining paghatag is a ministry. Kaya ang tao nga dili kabalo magpasalamat, di makaabot sa iyang adtuan. Tinuod na. So let's open first to Mark chapter 4. Verse 23 to 25. Mark chapter 4. Ato ning i-dissect atong tan-awon. Nagaingon. If any man have ears, na mamoy dunggan, di ba? Let him hear, and he said unto them, take heed of what you hear. Mga kaigsunan, bantayi, timani, susiha ang imong nadunggan. Because with what measure you met, it shall be measured to you. And unto you that hear, mga kaigsunan, shall more be given. For he that hath, to him shall be given, and he that hath not, from him shall be taken, even that which he hath. Mga kaigsunan, lisod-lisod ni nga in English. Bisan ko ako kasabot. Kaya, kining King James Version nga in English, mga kaigsunan, lisod-lisod ni, for example, for he that hath. Ha? Kanya, kung naa kay interpreter, ang hath, may mga kalo. Mauna nga, wala lang tayo interpreter ron, kaya tayong magsayop. Mga kaigsunan, here Jesus is not talking about riches, talents, blessings, or influence. He's talking about insight into the message. Unsa imong nasabtan? Kaya kung makasabot ka, mga kaigsunan, pwede ni mo mabuhat. Kaya ang mga tao nga di makasabot, di gin mo buhat. Ha? Mauna, Mark chapter 4 verse 24 explains that those who have wisdom into spiritual things receive that wisdom. Mga kaigsunan, mauna nga usahay, wala tay wisdom to do the thing because we were not able to receive. Ha? They hear, but they don't understand. When we continually fill our hearts with much of God's wisdom, mga kaigsunan, mabitaw na, very important nga ni atagayod sa simbahan. Dili ta mo absent, labi na ka ng Sunday school, mga kaigsunan, kay daghang wisdom tang makuha diha. Thou shalt not forsake the assembling because faith cometh by hearing and hearing the words of God. Mga kaigsunan, mabitaw na, kining Biblia, daghang wisdom diri nga makita na to. In fact, all scripture is given by the inspiration of God. And is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God or a woman of God may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto all good works. In fact, the Bible also states in John chapter 1 verse 1, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Mao na mga kaigsoonan, kung unsay gisulti sa Bible, it will give us wisdom. But we only accept sometimes a little of the truth. Mga kaigsoonan, daghan na mong nadunggan ng mga giwali diri, ng mga kamatuuran, pero ang gusto lang ninyong kamatuuran, mao inyong gusto. Di ba? For example, ibalik ko ni kaniadto, thou shalt not forsake the assembling. O sana, pero usahay absent lang ihapunta simbahan. Ha? Ikaduha, thou shalt not yoke yourselves with unbelievers. Kasabot ka ni ana, pero naalang gihapon mga Kristohanon nga mangita gyud og unbeliever kay walay gwapo lagi. Unya minsan, bring ye therefore all your tithes into the storehouse. Taguon lang gihapon ilang tithes, mga kaigsunan. Mao na ako ning gipareho ka nang mag-eskwela ka og foreign language. Mga kaigsunan, lisod kayo nang mag-eskwela ka og foreign language. For example, us, we have tried to study French. Naman na si Kabanggi, oh. Parang ako nag-eskwela ko og French. Ang akong teacher, si Pastor Mukindi, mga kaigsunan, pirtik stricto kayo nga teacher. Pati ang imong pronunciation, kanang sa dila ba? Ah, magkalisod-lisod na gani ko. Ako na yung ingnon nga. Tama nga pita. O niya, gusto man po siya kape. Kahuman na huwag kape-kape. Huwag man iskwi. Wala yung kunawa. Zero per me. Muna, a student who studies for years and spend time in an environment where the language is spoken will understand more and more. For example, dito ko sa Congo. Unya, kanang nag-eskwi lagi kong tininood. Unya, nakigistorya ko sa ila in French. Mga kaigsunan, makasabot ko. I can be able to be very, very fluent in speaking in French. But the problem was, sa among balay, we were speaking in English so that kini sila Kabanggi o ang uban, sila Junior, sila David, they will be able to understand English. Ang nahitabo, kami wakasabot og French, sila'y kabalog in English. Unya, mas mayo pag mong in English kontra nako. You hear Junior speak English. Si David, mayo na itong mga binisaya. If you stop practicing the language, mga kaigsunan, kung sa may mahitabo, di nagyud ka kabalo. I have heard David preach there in Congo. He was preaching in English. Somebody was interpreting in French. Ako nga nung dili man ka mag-preach in French. Magkalisod-lisod na ko pa. Kay nadugay-dugay naman diri. Nabisaya naman. Imbis nga. So, in English ang iyang preaching dito niya, naanay mo interpret in French. Mauna nga, dili nakakastorya sa language, mga kaigsoonan. So, sometimes you resort into using the smartphone apps so that you will be able to know the interpretation. Mga kaigsoonan, you will quickly forget everything. Puro pareho lang na sa atong knowledge sa Ginoo. Nadunggan mo karon, wala ni mo i-practice, mga kaigsoonan. Wala ni mo sabta, wala ni mo i-apply sa imong kinabuhi, nalimta na ni mo. Matthew chapter 15 verse 10. And he called the multitude and said unto them, hear and understand. Paminaw o sabta. Kay usahay na minaw ta, pero wala nato sabta. If any man have ears, let him hear and understand. Hear and understand. Because if you will not correctly understand the teachings, you will never receive the truth. Dili ka makabalo sa kamatuoran, mga kaigsuunan. The truth is very important. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one cometh unto the Father but by me. Ang ubang mga tao, labi na ning mga babae, mituo sila nga, love is the most important. Bahala na, pastor, basta higug malagi ko. Wala pa nga ninyo susiha kung tinuod ba na. Because ang tinuod nga gugma, kinahanglan og truth so that it can be a true love. Di ba? Kay usahay, ang gugma dili tinuod. Ha? Mauna, truth is necessary for love to become true love. You must know the truth. And the real truth is only in Jesus Christ, mga kaigsuunan. Yeah, truth is necessary to fulfill your ministry. Mauna nga, we can have all these things. Kung dili nimo masabtan ang kamatuoran, dili gyud ka kasunod. Mark 4:24. Nagaingon, with what measure, but ipasabot of understanding, o unsa imong gi-understand, you meet, it shall be measured to you. Jesus is saying that with whatever measure of understanding you have, when you give, your ability to receive will either be expanded or limited. Mga kaigsuunan, kung unsa ang imong understanding, maupod imong ability to follow. Na ay mga tao nga sining, Dong, palit nito yellow. Daganda yun nga ito, palit og yellow, pero wa siya kabalo, unsa yung yellow ang yang paliton. Ice ba o kulor? Wa man makasabot, mga kaigsunan. Kinanglang sabtong yun nimo. Aron, pagtuman nimo, sakto ang imong pagtuman. Ha? If you understand little, you will receive little. If you understand much, you will receive much. Maubitaw na nga usahay sa atong pagsunod sa atong Ginoo, gamay ra tay nadawat tungod kay gamay ra man puy atong understanding. Pero ang kamatuoran gud sa understanding, mga kaigsuunan, especially in terms of wisdom, wisdom starts from the fear of the Lord. Wagani kay kahadlok sa Ginoo, di yun ka kasabot, mga kaigsuunan. Kay kadaghan ka nato usahay, gihuna-huna nato o gisayon-sayon lang nato ang atong Ginoo. Daghan ninyo gisaad sa Ginoo, pero wala ninyo tumana. Oh. Tinuod dili. Bisan ako. Mambitaw na nga, usahay kita, maayo mang yung tamukanta. I surrender all. Pakurug-kurug pa. I surrender all. Pero, wagod mo surrender ba? Ha? Huh? Kinsa may misurrender, tinuod dire. Ngayon nga, tinuod, pastor, I surrender all. Kanang tinuod yun, may kantag, I surrender all. Wala no. Kay kung may alsa pa ka, ipasurrender ko yung cellphone dire. Tanawa, 3 John, chapter 2. Verse 2, 3 John. Beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prospereth. Mga kaigsunan, kadaghan ko ni gibasa-basa nga versikulo sa Bible. Kay gusto kong makita nga kada usa-usa ka nato, ganahan yun ang Ginoo nga mo prosper ta. Siguro, ang Ginoo, nagtanaw ka nato, unya, ang objective yun sa Ginoo, nga nung giluwas ka o giluwas ko, tungod kay ganahan ang Ginoo nga mo prosper ta. Mauna, miingon po si John nga, I pray above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health. Kanang mahilti ba ta? Even as thy soul prosper. Mga kaigsunan, siguro kung wala pa kong mo prosper, patay na ko ron. With all the things that had happened to me, duha ka operasyon sa kasing-kasing, mga kaigsunan, ang uban gani, wala pa operize kasing-kasing, patay na. If you notice John, he wants us to prosper and be in health. He said, he prayed for those things above all others. However, he placed a condition of whether or not we will receive it. And the condition is that your soul must prosper. Your soul must prosper. Mga kaigsunan, we have the physical body and the soul. Kauntag mga nindot nga pagkaon, mga kaigsunan, kada adlaw naakay mga vitamins, minerals, vegetarian ka pa, bisan unsa na lang imong kaunon aron manindot imong lawas, mag-exercise ka, mga kaigsunan, pero ang imong soul malnourished. Because the Bible says, man shall not live by bread alone, but by the words that cometh from the mouth of God. Diba? How many of us really read the Bible? Kay, usahay, mga kaigsunan, daladala lang nato ning Bible, pero pag-abot nato sa balay, dili nato basahon. Makabasa lang ta ning Bible during Sunday, kanang paablihan is pastor. Mukatawa mo, pero tinuod na. Tinuod na. Now, let us look what the Bible says so that we can understand. There was a Canaanite woman who has a problem. And she heard that Jesus will be coming. Pakakita yun niya kang Jesus Christ. Misinggit na yung siya, misinga, Jesus, Son of David, help me. My daughter is vexed with the devil. Nagpatabang. Ang iyang giingon, si Jesus is the Son of David. That means to say, he is a descendant of a king. But you know the answer of Jesus Christ? Ingon si Jesus Christ, it is not good for the bread to be given to the dogs. Ang pag-understand sa babae nga si Jesus Cristo is a king or a descendant of the king, but si Jesus Christ, lain ang iyang answer. He said, dili ko descendant of a king, I am a bread. Magkaiba, no? Son of David, unya mingon si Jesus Christ, I am a bread. Unya mingon siya, it is not meat for the bread to be given to the dogs. Pangutan-unta mo, si Jesus Christ was supposed to be given to the children. And the children was the Israelites. In fact, kita dili gani ta qualified, supposed to be a part of the ministry of Jesus Christ. Kaya na magipili na. Unya kadto nga woman, dili siya part kay Canaanite man. Mao na miingon si Jesus Christ, dili pwede ihatag ang bread ngadto sa dogs. Kita mga dogs rata, mga kaigsunan. Mga Gentiles man ta. Kung wala makasabot ang babae, mga kaigsunan, masuko siya. Kaya kung ingnon mo ni Pastor Gisalba nga, nga nung ari-ari man mong ramang kag-iro, mga kaigsunan, di nakambalik. Kamatura na. Kaya kita, taas tayo tag-pride, kaya wala man ta kasabot. Labi na kung wala kang kasabot nga, labi na sa Espiritu Santo, wala pa musulti ni mo. Pero ang woman, nakasabot. She was able to understand and the answer was quite marvelous and wonderful. Miingon ang babae, true Lord, I am just a dog. But even dogs has a part of things that will fall under the table. Makakaon man ang dog kung under the table, dili on the table, but under the table, the crumbs that fall under the table. Kay ang imong mga anak, mga salbais, wala man ayuha pagkaon ang pagkaon na hagbong. Mauna kita, nakakaon lang taghagbong because we are in a fallen state. You are able to see that? Huh? Nya, mikaon ang miingon, mao to miingon si Hesus Kristo. What a great faith that you have. Kaya nakakita siya. Mga kaigsunan, atong sabton, kung kinsa si Hesus Kristo, para ka na to. Ang babae, nangayog tabang. Pero si Hesus Kristo, wal, miingon siya, murag miingon siya nga, wala kumuari, aron mutabang kanimo nga, as if I am a carabao that will flow the field, or a waiter that will give you the food. I am here as a bread. And therefore, because I am a bread, you must eat me. Nakasabot mo? Si Hesus Kristo, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Kay Word man siya, mga kaigsunan, kung imo siyang kaunon, unya imong basahon, imong ibutang sa imong kaugalingon, He becomes a part of you. Unya, tungod kay ang Ginoo, naa naman kanimo, ang Ginoo is a part of you, the power of the Lord will be in you. Kung naa kay problema, ingon ang Ginoo, kaun. Kaun. Then I remember the prodigal son, mga kaigsunan. Maldito man. Father, give me my inheritance. O niya, gi-squander niya ang inheritance sa iyang father, mga kaigsunan. So, dihang wa na gikaon. Maunong yun yung tao, kanang may kahinomdom lang sa Ginoo kung nagkalisod na. You know, I will go back to my father kay maayo man dito kay bisan ang among mga sulugon kakaon man. So, ako lang gitanaw po mga kaigsunan, ang tatay, with all the money that he has, wag yun niya pangita iyang anak, hangtod ang iyang anak nang mibalik. Mga kaigsunan, very important nga mubalik yun sa Ginoo. Kay usahay baya ni amo diri pero gipangita kas Ginoo. Eh, naala ka diha, pero wala diha. Ang imong panghuna-huna ba? So, pagbalik niya mga kaigsunan, nakitaan siya sa amahan, gisugat yun. Ha? The father meet him, gipatagaan o grove. Buti pasabot mga kaigsunan, kung kita na, kay makasasala man ta, gitagaan ka grove, gitagaan ka na o damit niya. Murag luwas na baka, dili na, tarong na ta. Dili na ta, hugaw nga pagkatao, tarong ng atong sinina. Gitagaan pagsingsing mga kaigsunan. Pagpapasabot nga, child of God gun siya. Ha? Tagapagsyus mga kaigsunan. Pero, ang katapusan, miingon ang amahan. Hala, kuha ang baka, aron atong lutuon, atong litsunon. Ngano man, bisan luwas na ka, gutumon ka pa. Gigutom tao eh. Mauna nga, kitang mga luwas, kinahanglan mo kaunta. Kung tinuod kang luwas, giandaman tas Ginoo ug pulong sa Dios aron masatisfy gyud ta mga kaigsoon. Hear and understand. Hear and understand. Our soul is our intellect and our understanding. So John was saying, our understanding of God's word must increase, mga kaigsoonan. Usahay, ato malaning sayon-sayonon, daghang kayo ninyong makamemorya dayo, no? Especially kanang John 3.16, mauragoy akong namemorya na, John 3.16. God so loved the world. Pas-pas kayo. Oh? Kay, maura, pero, explain. Wala explanation. Mga kaigsunan, before God can prosper us, huh? And we can have the divine health, mga kaigsunan, kinahanglan, we will have to understand what the Word of God is. Pasalamat as Ginoo nga, mga buhi pata. Ako kada adlaw nagpasalamat ko sa Ginoo nga, Lord, thank you so much that I am still alive. Walay problema sa pagkatulog. Ang problema pagmata. Kay di ka kabalo kung kamata ka ugma. Mga kaigsunan, maubitaw na ayaw mong hinambog. Nga batan-on pa mo kay kanang lungon, kakita kong lungon gamay, o lumunda at dako. Pari-pariho rata. Mauna nga, kung ikaw masakiton, usahay ang masakiton, maupay mabuhi kontra sa mga kanang maayog lawas. So, ang importante mga kaigsunan, sunod tas Ginoo. Ha? Sunod sa Ginoo. Beloved, I pray above all that you might prosper and be in health, even as your understanding increases. Mauna ang buti pasabot ni ini. Even as your understanding increases. Kay usahay mga kaigsunan, sige lang tagbasa, watay understanding. 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 3. The Bible says, according as His divine power hath given us all things that pertains unto life and godliness through the knowledge of Him that hath called us to glory and virtue. Mga kaigsunan, His divine power has given us everything we need for life and godliness through our understanding of what Jesus tells us. Ang problema, mga kaigsunan, nakasabot bata. Do we understand? Kay usahay, mga kaigsunan, wa nakasabot. Hinoon, the Bible says nga, di gyud nakasabot kung wa ta maluwas. Romans chapter 3 verse 10 and 11, the Bible says, as it is written, no one is righteous, no not one. Nobody understand it, nobody seek it after God. Di ta kasabot mga kaigsoon, bisan unsa ni mugbasa sa Bible, di ta kasabot kung di ta gyud luwas. Kaya nga noon, wala man si Jesucristo pa sa atong mga kasing-kasing. Mao na nga, kung ikaw niya karon nga wala pa si Kristo sa imong kasing-kasing, siguro agyud. O kung ikaw membro na simbahan, siguro agyud. Kay usahay membro ta pero wa ta kasabot. So nga no, wa man ta kasabot. Tingali apil ta sa Romans chapter 3 verse 11, nobody understand. Ha? Nobody seek after God. Wala ka paghihapon magpalo sa atong Ginoong Hesukristo. Mga kaigsoonan. So try to understand. Tingali di pataluwas. Proverbs chapter 10 verse 23. Kini. The blessings of the Lord, it make it rich, and add it no sorrows with it. Mga kaigsunan, we have to understand that God wants to bless us, and His blessings will have no sorrows from them. Mga kaigsunan, kadaghan sa mga nag-ampo, Ginoo, please, tagay kong husband, blessingi ko, giblessingan ka. Nakakita na blessing yun sa Ginoo, tamya gisumbag siya pa. Dili na blessing kay na may soro. Ha? Ang blessing sa Ginoo nagsingon, no sorrows with it. But sometimes mga kaigsunan, we don't believe it. We don't believe it. Look at it, Romans 8:23. Kini ako yun yung kanunay giklaim sa Ginoo. I believe that I am a child of God. And as a child of God, mga kaigsunan, ang Ginoo akong amahan. Mauna nga, makikistorya ko sa akong amahan. Kini manggod, nag-ingon manggod, He that spared not His own Son, but delivered Him as for us, how shall He not with Him also freely give us all things? Mga kaigsunan, only bigatin san. Buti pasabot bigatin nga ni waylain. Ha? Kung waylain, mga kaigsunan, gihatag niya kanato waylain nga ika-replace, mga kaigsunan, how can He not freely give you all things? Mauna nga usahay, kung dili ta kasabot ni ini mga kaigsoonan, naagyon tayong mga doubts. I believe that God is love. Unya kay God is love, dili gud na siya mo likoy sa iyang pagkahigugma or paggugma. Kay gugma gud siya. Therefore, His will for me is always the best. And His will for you is the best. Ikaduhang akong nabaluan, God is all-knowing. Therefore, His direction is always right. All-knowing good. Nakasabot siya kung asa ka padulong. Unya, dili gyud niya ipaadto ka ni anang lugar. Ang problema, ikaw may ganahan mo adto. Ha? Mauna nga, kung tawagong kas Ginoo sa ministry, ayaw pagbalibad kay kabalo ang Ginoo nga para na sa imong kaayuhan. Ha? Kamu nga mga Bible student, ni anamang gyud mo dire. Huna-hunaan ninyo nga dili aksidente nga ni amo dire. Ha? From the foundation of the world, God knew you already. Ha? John 15:16, you have not chosen me but I have chosen you. Can you imagine God chose you already? Ha? You have not chosen me but I have chosen you and ordained you. Ha? That you go and bear much fruit. Mauna nga ni amo dire so that eventually after your training kay gi-equip mo diri sa atong eskwelahan aron makabalo mo pagsulwining etc. Like that mga kaigsoonan, you can go and bear much fruit. And your fruit should remain. Ha? Kanang inyong fruit nga dili mo remain, disqualified na. Your fruit should remain that whatsoever you ask of the Father in my name, that I shall do. Ang atong gimemorya man lang kanang whatsoever you ask. Kay ganahan man lang ta sige pangayo. Mga kaigsoonan, nindot ang mangayo ta. Kay mingon man Ginoo, iya man ang promise whatsoever you ask in my name, that I shall do. Wala ba mo ingon ang Ginoo nga some of the things you ask. Mingon sa whatsoever you ask. Mao na nga, ako ning giklaim sa Ginoo. When God give Jesus to us, then He give to us everything. Mabita na mo yung tanga, Jesus is enough. Kaya nga no, He owns everything. Kung nakasabot ka, kung kinsa ang imong amahan, di ka kuyawan. Ang problema ka nato, we doubt because we don't understand. Remember, God is the owner of gold and silver. He is the owner of the universe. God will not withhold nothing from us. Kaya ang gusto sa Ginoo, mga kaigsoonan, mingon siya, I have come that you might have life and you will have it more abundantly. Pero kinahanglan makasabot ta. Let us understand because nagatan-aw ta sa ability sa Ginoo, dili sa atong ability. Ha? John 8:32. And ye shall know the truth, and the truth that you know shall make you free. Mga kaigsoonan, mau bitaw na sa John 1:12, nagaingon, but as many as receive him. Nga nung Batman, because not all will believe. Dili tanan mo dawat. Mauna nga bat. Mauna, gitagaan ka nagkamatuoran, pero wala ni mo dawat ang kamatuoran, wala ni mo sabt ang kamatuoran, wala ni mo ihatag ang kamatuoran sa imong kaugalingon. Kaya nga naman, wala ni mo dawata si Kristo. Mauna, nag-ingon diri, and He shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. But it is not the truth that sets you free, but the truth that you know and you understand that can set you free. I know my Jesus Christ. sa dihang miingon ang nagwali during that time nga ni ako diri kay mga kaigsoonan, kung backslider mo, labaw pa ko. Katoliko gud ko, sa Kristan ko, di ko mutuo o kanang laing relihiyon. Pero kay mutuo ko, guwapa. Guwapa man tong nag-ano yun, nag-invite na ako. Moto nga, dito ko, mga kaigsoonan. Unya, na ay nagwali about Jesus Christ. Unya, nakasabot man ko. Pag-ingon niya, dawaton mo si Kristo, nga personal mong manluluwas, mga kaigsoonan, mitindog ko. And everything is history. Pero kung ikaw, midawat ka lang, kay pareho ka niya itong akong gisuluiningan, nga mayon kang, nung imo bang dawaton si Kristo, nga imong personal nga manluluwas, nga dawaton ko mangganing tuba, ka na pa, mga kaigsoonan. Wa ka kasabot. Ha? Wa ka kasabot. O hangtod karon bisa naa ka diha, naglingkod-lingkod ka diha, wala ka gihapon kasabot. If we continue to understand the Word of God, we will continually increase our ability to receive. Mabitaw na, katong naalamang tinuod nga ministry, kanang tinuod nga nagtrabaho para sa Ginoo, katong nakasabot. Kay pwede kang magpakaroon nun nga, naa kay ministry, daghang mga Bible students nga, ay pastor, dito ko, daghang ko gisulwining pastor. Sa isinta kabuk ang nagdawat sa Ginoo, pero dito ragot to sa SM siya. Mga kaigsoon, usahay, napoy mga ingon ni ano niya, pagbaptisim po, napoy nagbaptisim nga, pabaptisim na dito kay iyang bayran. Mga kaigsoonan, dili na mao ang ministry. Ang ministry is honesty. Kaya it is between you and God. Dili na between you and Pastor Gisalba or between you and any pastor, mga kaigsoonan. It is between you and God. Ha? Mauna, tanawa ang istorya ni Solomon, First King. Chapter 3, verse 5 and 14. Dini ko muhunong. The Bible says, in Gibeon, the Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream by night, and God said, ask what I shall give thee. Mga kaigsoonan, ang Ginoo ganahan nga kita mangayo tas Ginoo. Ask what shall I give thee. Unya, Solomon said, thou hast showed unto thy servant David, my father, great mercy, according as he has walked before thee in truth, and in righteousness, and in uprightness of heart with thee. And thou hast kept for him this great kindness, that thou hast given him a son, and sit on his throne, as it is in that day. Mga kaigsoonan, the reason Solomon is there in the throne is because of David. Mabitaw na, kining atong mga anak, naka-inherit na sa blessing nga gihimo sa amahan. Muto mo dili. Mauna nga, kamo nga mga amahan, kamo nga mga inahan, let us be honest to God. Tanawa kung sa igiingon ni Solomon. Si Solomon may acknowledge ni ini. Misya, Lord, and Solomon said, thou hast showed unto thy servant David, my father, great mercy. Ha? Gitagaan o dako nga pagtagad sa Ginoo. Ha? O kaluoy si David. Mga kaigsoonan. Nga naman, kini ang giingon, according as he has walked before you in truth and in righteousness. Kita nga mga anak na sa Ginoo, let us walk in righteousness, in uprightness of heart, and in the truth, mga kaigsoonan. Ha? And thou hast kept for him this great kindness, that thou hast given a son, him a son, gitagaan siyang anak, nga mulingkod sa trono. Ha? Mga kaigsoonan, nindot kayo, nagpasalamat ko sa Ginoo nga ang akong anak na pastor. I never dream nga magpastor siya. Kaya niadto sa pastor pa ko, ganahan ko ang akong mga anak magdoktor, maglawyer, mga kaigsoonan, kay pastor siguro ko binuang lang to. Kaya wa pa man ko kasabot. But when God killed me, when God allowed me to experience death, and when God gave me back my life, then I came to realize that the most important thing in this world is our obedience to God. Mauna nga, inyong mga anak, ayaw mo paghunahuna nga, nindot kayong iyang kurso, doktor, lawyer, etc. mga kaigsoonan, kay daghang kog mga classmate nga doktor, kay istorya na ko mga kaigsoonan, perting bisiya sa ilang trabaho. Oh, mayo pa ko. Bisan di ko kakita, lingkod-lingkod lang ko. Ah, malipayon ko na ako'y asawa nga nag-itindis ako. Ah. Mauna mga kaigsoonan, kamo, iampo yung mga anak nga musunod o Ginoo. Ha? Nga, kanang naay manguyab ninyong anak nga, pasturuno na, pero kundi gwapo, ayaw na lang. Seven. Mga tawa lagi mo. And now, O Lord my God, thou hast made thy servant king instead of David my father, and I am a little child. I know not how to go. How to go out and to come in. Unya, kini ang giingon ni Solomon. And thy servant is in the midst of thy people which thou hast chosen. A great people that cannot be numbered nor counted for multitude. Give therefore thy servant an understanding heart, huh? To judge thy people, that I may discern good and bad. For who is able to judge this thy so great a people? Mga kaigsoonan, the one that Solomon asked was understanding. Huh? Onya, verse 10, nagaingon. And the speech bless the Lord that Solomon had asked this thing. And God said unto him, because thou hast asked these things, and hast not asked for thyself long life, neither hast asked riches for thyself, nor hast asked the life of thine enemies, but hast asked for thyself understanding to discern judgment. Behold, I have done according to thy words. Lo, I have given thee a wise and understanding heart, so that there was none like thee before thee, neither after thee shall any arise like unto thee. And I have given thee that which thou hast not asked. Wa ang gihatag pagod, katong wala niya pangalo, both riches and honor, so that thee shall not be any among the kings like unto thee all thy days. And if thou wilt walk in my ways, mga kaigsoonan, mauni ang gisulti sa Ginoo, ha? And if you will walk in my ways to keep my statutes and my commandments, as thy father David did walk, then I will lengthen thy days. Mga kaigsoonan, nindot ang gisulti sa Ginoo nga to kang Solomon. O kung tinuod na kang Solomon, tinuod na para ka na to. Nga kung naa kay understanding, naa kay pagsabot sa pulong sa Dios, unya kita obedient as Ginoo, unya miingon ang Ginoo siya, if you will walk in my ways, huh? To keep my statutes and my commandments, as thy father David did walk, then I will lengthen thy days. Now, when he is Pastor Gisalba, he is a testimony of what God is saying. Hinaot unta makaabot ni anang idara nga, pero kung makaabot ang idara nga ang imong linakwan inguna ni ana, bahala na lang uy mamatay. Tinuod bitaw I visited my brother, 80 years old. Naluoy ko sa akong brother. Kaya pagtanda ko niya, wala siya ngipon. Oh. Lama siya ngipon niya, pustiso, pwede niya ibutang. Ako nga, hindi man ka butang pustiso. Nga nung butang pagpustiso. Kung man naman kong trabaho, di man kining akong kinaboy, di man pinaakay. Hinoon. Kaya, ang iyang linakwan mga kaigsunan, ingon na niya na, ako nga, nakainom doon kong Pastor Gisalba, nindot kayo glinakwan ba? Murag ulita, walang gyapon. Mao na ilinakwan sa kanang anak sa Ginoo. Kanang linakwan nga ingon niya na, kanang mga purdoy na. Mao na nga ako, bisan di ko kakita, may ingon na lang ko nga, ingon gyapon nga lakwan. Na ba? Kakita bitaw kog Amerikano dito sa kwan kanang diya sa Jones ba? Nagunang asawa. Ingon ang Amerikano kay tigulang naman. Nakakita bitaw og nindot og lawas bagwapa. Una. Mauna have understanding. Naka-understand to siya. Mauna ang mga kingsunan. The one that opened the graces from heaven over King Solomon's life was understanding. He received from God. He did not ask for long life, mga kingsunan. Usahay, kita, sige, nagpangayog long life. Lino, please, daghan na kagastos, mga kingsunan. Vitamins, minerals, bisan unsa na lang imong gipalit. Unya, nagpalit ka pag garlic, napay olive oil, mahimo ka ng inununan. Daghan na kayong imong gipalit. Si Solomon, he simply sought after understanding. And God met his every need. Usay, magsubra ta. Mauna, so how will we do this? Number one. Gusto ko, balik mong number one. Nabi tayo nagwali mo itong mga kaigsunan. Ako, ang akong wali karon aron maintindihan ninyo, place. Aron makasabot mo, pako. Ha? Pako nga place ba sa Manila? Sa number one, point, P. Oh, yeah, sub-point, daghan sub-point, 30 minutes good pee pa lang. A, another 30 minutes. C, another 30 minutes mga kaigsunan. O, pagka umang giniwali, naimidol niya, Pastor, salamat Pastor ha, nga wa ka magwali ng nubalitsis. Dugay-dugay ito. Mauna, number one. So how will we do it? Gamay na kayo ni. Pila ni kabok? Number one. Seek the Lord. Seek the Lord. Proverbs 28 verse 5. Evil men understand not judgment, but they that seek the Lord understand all things. Kung magsikta sa Ginoo, makasabot ta mga kaigsunan. Understand all things. Number two, shun evil. Daniel 12 verse 10. Many shall be purified and many will be tried, but the wicked shall do wickedly. Shun evil. Number three, walk in faith. Mga kaigsunan, walk in faith. Hebrews 11, 1 to 3. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for, evidence of things not seen. For by it, the elders obtain a good report. Through faith, we understand that the world were framed by the word of God, so that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. Mga kaigsunan, tanawa lang gundi. Through faith we understand that the world were framed by the word of God. So that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. Mabitaw na usa lang na pulong sa Ginoo mabagong imong kinabuhi. Pero kinahanglan musunod yun sa Ginoo. 4. Study the word of God. 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 15. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needed not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. And then number 5, mga kaigsunan, have the prayer of a disciple. Mga kaigsunan, sa atong kinabuhi, importante nga we will understand. Kaya kung di takasabot sa pulong sa Diyos, sige lang tagpaminaw, paminaw, paminaw, unya paggawas nimo, maulang gihapon imong kinabuhi. Mga kaigsunan, di yun kakapulfill sa imong ministry. But God wants each and every one of us to prosper. And we can only prosper if we understand. Let us pray. Ever hit